I'm over here trying not to get all choked up myself. So
I thought before I went into this, I thought I'd heard it enough times that I was like, I'll be all right. Welcome back. Unframe of Mind Show is back at it again with another video we're gonna watch, but definitely not react to. It's more of a audio, so you know, because they don't have an official video, but I thought the song was amazing and I wanted Anthony to hear it and I wanted to see his reaction myself.
The only song I've heard off of this album is Houdini, so I have not had a chance to go through his catalog of songs on this album. So yeah, the only one I really got kind of a taste of was the one with Jelly Roll. I maybe listened to about 30 seconds of that one. I thought that was great, just from what I've heard, but I have not heard any of the other songs yet. So.
Gotcha. Okay, yeah, the album, from what I've seen, is a lot of people aren't getting it. It's a concept album where Eminem is, Marshall Mathers is battling his alter ego Slim Shady through the whole thing. And right. A lot of people are hearing these lyrics, these offensive lyrics that Slim Shady spits on the album. And they're going, oh, Eminem's trying to be all edgy and cool. And he's trying to get himself, you know, nobody cares. And it's funny because it's like those people are just not getting the concept. Or
they didn't grow up with Slim Shady.
Yeah, or something like that. Yeah, but it's hilarious. So let's begin, shall we?
Yeah, let's do it.
Eminem's new album, The Death of Slim Shady, and the song is called Temporary, featuring Skylar Grey. Here we go.
A lot of people ask me, am I afraid of death? The truth is, I think what scares me the most is not being able to say all the things I want to say to you when I'm no longer here. So this song is for Haley, for when that day comes.
Where's Haley? Where's she at?
This ain't Haley.
Who is it?
It's so much.
Ah! I've been waiting all night for the sunrise to take away the dark sky.
There are monsters, and there are baby monsters, and I'm a monster.
All it takes is a new sometimes to get me in a better state of mind.
Give me a kiss, monster. Love you.
If I could just fall asleep, I'd be lost in a dream. But right now it's misery, and I just have to remember that when a heart breaks, it ain't broken forever. The pieces will grow back together, and in time
so Haley Jade, I wrote you this song to help you cope with life now that I'm gone. How should I start? Just wanna say, look after Elena, Stevie, and Uncle Nate. And sweetie, be strong. I know I was your rock, and I still am. Saying goodbye is just not ever easy. But why you crying? Just stop. Haley, baby, dry your eye, this is not forever.
So when a heart breaks, it ain't broken forever. The pieces will grow back together. And in time, I'll be fine. The tears are temporary.
Daddy! Ooh.
What?
When I used to have this, I was a little kid.
Baby, are you okay? Baby, are you okay?
Daddy! Daddy!
Yeah. And you will get over me and move on. You can play me on repeat on a song. But don't you dare shed a tear, what I tell you. Straighten up, little soldier, them times when I held you. Jade, it'll be okay, baby, I'm here. Hey, I'm watching you right now. Baby girl, I vow I will protect you, your guardian angel. As hard as this may feel, us parting is painful. And darling, the rain will drive you insane still. You will remain strong. Haley, just hang on, it won't be too long. I need you to move on. And remember, it will get better. This time heals and
when a heart breaks, it ain't broken forever. The pieces will grow back together. And in time, I'll be fine. The tears are temporary. The bad days will start to get better. Then we'll be laughing together. And tonight, when I cry, the tears are temporary.
I know this big girl. Really pretty. You know what her name is?
Haley.
Haley.
How did you know?
Yeah, and if there's days where you wanna just lock yourself in your room and cry, just think about how when you were little, how you and I, back and forth to the studio, we used to drive, you strapped in the back seat, cause you were my little sidekick. Yeah, sweetie, I know this hurts, Bean, I'm wishing your pain away. Remember this, Haley Jade, there's gonna be rainy days, I promise you'll get through them and make it regardless. Fuck it, Jade, I'll be honest, I knew that you was gonna take this the hardest. Sweetie, get up, I know that this is breaking your heart, is the hardest thing I've ever wrote. Haley, sweetheart, it's okay for you to let me go. Baby, I promise you that when a
heart breaks, it ain't broken forever. The pieces will grow back together, and in time, I'll be fine. The tears are temporary. The bad days will start to get better, then we'll be laughing together. And tonight, when I cry, the tears are temporary.
What's your favorite song?
Your favorite song?
What's your favorite part, Dad? You're taping me, bitch.
I got you on tape, cousin.
Can you hear?
Yep.
No, bitch.
No what?
No, I said no, bitch.
Okay, no cousin, no cousin, no cousin, no cousin.
All right.
You know, we've done a lot of these reactions, and sometimes you kind of come across those songs or videos that that kind of hit you in that spot where you just want to let it play and not interrupt it. You know, yeah. Some songs have that ability to do that, to be able to do that. This one did it. I didn't want you to stop it. I think it's beautiful that, you know, he came from doing Mockingbird, and then to kind of wrap up his career, it's kind of like his way of signing off of, you know, his life and his music career, and reminding his girls to, you know, yeah, just never yeah. forget me, you know. So
yeah, that hit me, man, because I'm sitting there like, you know, I've got three daughters, and I immediately sent it to all of them, and I said, listen, if this song ever starts playing in the car, I'm going to need you to take over for driving for me immediately. Like, this, I'm not going to be able to hold it together. Like, it's, and even right now, I've already heard this song like five times. And it's like, it just, I'm trying to make sure that my daughters remember me well. And I really hope that this is, I'm just blabbering at this point. So just feel free to hop in.
No, I get it, dude. I mean, I was...
Oh, fuck, man. It's beautiful. It was beautiful. And after this album, like, I haven't yet had a chance to go back and listen to the other four songs that are after this one, because, you know, I spent the whole evening, I'm working, I got it in my headphones, I'm playing, and I'm laughing, I'm just having a good time listening to this album, and all of a sudden this song comes on, and before I know it, I'm just sitting down, and I'm just listening. I'm just like, this is, oh my God, holy crap. This is beautiful. It's like one of those songs, reminds me of, Wings for Marie, 10,000 Days album by Tool.
Yeah.
Where he writes a song to his, about his mom passing away of terminal cancer. And it's like that beautiful poetry that you know, I wish I could write half as good as that. Like, it's so good. So good.
I think that's one of the reasons why, you know, people love Eminem so much, is that he is able to express the way he feels about his family, his friends, and obviously his fans. And that's something that, you know, sometimes we have a hard time being able to articulate those feelings and expressing how we feel towards others. And he's able to do it in such a way because he's such a great lyricist that, you know, we can depend on him to give us songs like this that can articulate how we feel through him and say, this is, you know, we can share that with our daughters and, you know, and kind of relate to that. I'm trying not to get choked up myself because, you know, I got girls myself, but, cause you just want the best for them, you know? And I think that through all of the controversy that Eminem has had over the years, I think the driving force behind his career has always been those girls. You can't tell me otherwise. But so for him to, I think this is his last album, you know, in his career. And if that's the case, I can't imagine a better song to dedicate to, you know, Haley and his daughters. And yeah, I'm over here trying not to get all choked up myself. So
I thought before I went into this, I thought I'd heard it enough times that I was like, I'll be all right.
No. Yeah. I don't know. The more I talk about it, the more I'm kind of like you, you know. It's just, like I said, sometimes those songs kind of give you, they hit you in such a way where I know we're supposed to react. I know we're supposed to stop it, but sometimes you can't, you just got to let it play. And yeah.
It's beautiful, dude. Beautiful. All right. So are we adding this one to the playlist?
But I think for all the right reasons, obviously. So
yeah, for sure. I'm mad. That's 10 out of 10, 10 out of 10 song. I can't fault it for anything. So yeah. If you enjoyed this song and maybe you have your own reaction, cause we definitely didn't. We don't react. So I don't know what the hell you think you just watched, but there wasn't.
We didn't get teary eyed. There wasn't dust in our rooms.
No, I'm not crying. You're crying.
I'm not crying. Are you crying?
No, bro. I appreciate you watching that with me. I'm glad I got to share that moment with you before you had a chance to listen to it.
Well, and I think that's what's different between us and a lot of other reactors is we've been friends for a long time and we both have girls and, you know, we both have had our struggles and we've always been there for one another as dads. And, you know, so to hear that, it piles on top of everything else that we have in that close relationship as friends with daughters. So yeah, it's beautiful.
All right. I guess you've been watching the Unframe of Mind show where we have uncomfortable conversations without a condom. And until next time, folks.
Haley, sweetheart, it's okay for you to let me go. Baby, I promise you that when I